to our worship this morning, celebrating the Reformation as well as the public confession affirmation of faith from our youth today. Welcome friends and family also that has gathered here to join us in worship. Our order of service is fully printed in the worship folder as well as on our PowerPoint. Let us join our voices together for our first song, Amazing Grace, and let us rise. Congregation may be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Beloved brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today we rejoice that these youth desire to publicly speak their baptismal faith before the church and continue in the journey of that faith within the Christian community and within the world. Jesus says, "Whoever speaks about me before others, I will also speak about them before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever refuses to speak about me before others, I will also refuse to speak about them before my Father who is in heaven." Dear children of the Heavenly Father, in baptism, our Lord Jesus Christ received you and made you members of his body, the church. In our Lord's community of faith, you have learned from the scriptures, from Luther's small catechism, from booklets baptized, we live in a place at the table, our Father's saving plan and his purpose for you in his creation. As baptized believers, you are witnesses to the message of Jesus Christ, who died on a cross and rose from the dead for the hope of all the world. Now I ask you to publicly speak the faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church, the faith in which we baptize. Do you renounce the forces of evil, the devil, and all his empty promises? Please answer, I do.
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty?
Yes, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son?
Yes, I do.
Amen.
you believe in the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, and the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Now that you have publicly spoken of your faith, do you intend to continue in the promises God made with you in baptism? To live in worship among our Father's faithful people, to hear his word, and eat and drink the holy communion of Jesus' body and blood, to publicly speak the good news of God's gift in Jesus Christ to the world through your words and actions, to serve all people, following the example of our Lord, and as a branch of the vine, live in Christ and grow in faith-filled works of love before the world. Please answer. And now, people of God, do you promise to support these young people and pray for them in their Christian lives?
We do, and ask God to help and guide us.
At this time now, I will call upon Daniel Figuero. He's going to come forward and assist me in the reading of the names and the confirmation verses that our youth have chosen. You can just let him through. He'll come through here. Oh, you can come here, Daniel. Okay, right up here by me. Okay, then you can take your seat. I'm going to put this in. Yes. So we'll start with Ava here.
Ava Cornensis Alexandrino. Romans 15, verse 2. Let each one of us please our neighbor for his or her good to build them up.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Ava the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, strengthen her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
Jenna Grace Costco, 1 John chapter 4, verse 19. We love God because he first loved us.
Jenna Grace Costco, Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Jenna the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, strengthen her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Hunter the gift of your Holy Spirit, confirm his faith, guide his life, strengthen him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen.
Grace Vivian Catherine Rapp, from Isaiah chapter 43, verse 2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Grace the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm her faith, guide her life, strengthen her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and bring her to everlasting life. Amen.
David Noah John Paul Rapp, Joshua chapter 1, verses 9. Be strong and courageous, do not be frightened, and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Noah the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm his faith, guide his life, strengthen him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen. Gracious Lord, through water and the word your Spirit made these young women and men your own. You forgave them all their sins and brought them to newness of life. Continue to strengthen them with your Spirit, and daily may they grow in your grace and you increase in their hearts your gifts, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Let us now rejoice with our young brothers and sisters in Christ our Lord. We rejoice with you in your baptismal life. Together we give thanks and praise to God our Father and proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ to all the world. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's wait for everybody to stand. You guys are awesome. And now, Ava, you just leave them back down here and then you go back to your seat. You can follow me. We now continue with our choir anthem.
Old Testament reading comes from Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 31 to the 34. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sorry. The epistle comes from Romans chapter 3, verses 19 to 29. St. Paul writes, Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced, and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight but by deeds prescribed by the law, for through the law comes the knowledge of sin. But now, irrespective of law, the righteous of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and prophets and the righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all those who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of an atonement by his blood. Effective through faith, he did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. And what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by law. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. They answered him, We are descendants of Abraham, and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying, You will be made free? Jesus answered them, Very truly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The son has a place there forever. So if the son makes you free, you will be free indeed.
Plants need to get new with our faith. We needed to be rooted in God's Word, the Bible. We need to be reading the Bible and studying it and hearing Pastor as he preaches and teaches to us about God's Word. And when that happens, then our roots of faith grow. And we become strong in the Lord. And what's so neat is we have so many young people doing that, sticking their roots in even more and helping them grow even more. And that's what we're praying about today as well. And eventually, we will all, right, profess our faith, even as we thank God for that faith that he gives to us. Heavenly Father, we thank you for continuing to help us grow in our faith and plant those roots in your word so that we are hearing you each and every day and following you. Be with us each and every day. In Jesus' name we pray.
this is the usual posture we had when we were doing all of our lessons for the past year. Downstairs, Sunday mornings. Now, most of us are used to calling today Confirmation Day. But confirmation actually already happened to them on the day of their baptism. And that's true about what we believe about confirmation. Because that's the actual official point in time when a baby is baptized that the Holy Spirit descends into the life of that child or adult or baby with the water and the word. The godparents, sponsors, parents, now they give witness to that faith. They say the Apostles' Creed on that day, and it's spoken by the entire church, in fact. And you all share in that witness and those words. So today we have their public affirmation of that very same baptismal faith. Only we adults didn't say that today. Today these young people have said the creed words out loud. And that is a witness, a strong witness, a witness to faith. And in a world where faith and trust is not always in large supply, their witness today encourages all of us. God's gift of faith to them as infants is still strong and secure as it was then. Faith does come by hearing the gospel. In fact, in the time in church we have immerses all of us into a regular exposure to Jesus. Only what these kids got to do in our time of learning was to look more closely at the content, the things of what their faith is. To learn that loving God and loving their neighbor as themselves is still the way Jesus moves us all along. It's the greatest commandment as it is the simplest of the commands. And trusting faith believes this. I'm actually overjoyed to say that each one of them has this trusting faith. And trust never goes away, or it shouldn't. Jesus never stops being there for them. The Holy Spirit doesn't just fly away. This isn't a graduation from Sunday school. It isn't a farewell from church. This is seeing church and worship and faith from just a different viewpoint. If any of them are like me, and I know some of them are, they like still hanging on to a few of the old toys. Some of you out there might be the same as me. I still have a lot of those Hot Wheels and Matchbox cars that I had from kindergarten days. And I still like them, but I don't play with them anymore. But I treasure them. They hold value. Well, trusting faith is kind of like that. It's valuable because it's a gift from God. And it is free, it is simple, it is peaceful, it is hopeful, it is joyful, and free is good. And Jesus tells us that he sets us free. And he tells us what he sets us free from. From being locked up to our fears, our troubles, our trials, our failings, our worries, and the struggles with other people. Jesus doesn't want any of us locked up to any of those fears or troubles. We make a prison of predicaments, you might say, that way. And fear is the worst, because it's the easiest negative motivator in all things of life. And if you think about that, you know that's quite correct. Just look at the Ten Commandments. Why do we break any of them? Because we don't love and trust in God above all things. Whether it's lying or gossiping or the little ways we kill each other, stealing, breaking vows and promises and envy and jealousy and all those things, we do that because deep down we're all afraid of not getting things the way we want. It's that simple. Fear doesn't trust. Fear tries to control the outcome at all costs. There's an old saying, mile by mile is a trial. Yard by yard is hard, but inch by inch, well, that's a cinch. And worry looks that way because it looks always at the whole picture, always up ahead, and how are we going to get to that point where day by day through Christ, he gets us through those hard times, whether it's the fear we worry if it's as simple as embarrassment, which we have, or being unprepared, caught off guard. And Jesus knows that. He knows what bugs us. He's well aware of how captive we are to the negative things. He's constantly telling us that we don't have to be or feel or live a certain way that isn't the way he gives us. We're all enslaved to sin, and yet we're all forgiven people captive to Jesus. He sets us free that we can live connected to Him and only Him, and that way we live connected to each other. That's really our identity. And that's something we did focus on a lot in our studies, identity. Knowing who we are and trusting who we belong to. And that sets us on that gospel path for life. Jesus is with us inside. He never leaves us, which is why days will also appear troublesome. If Jesus got crucified and He lives in us, then we will face some hard times too. But He's also alive. Easter came. He rose from the dead. And we will travel down our roads all the time, guided by that death and resurrection of Christ every moment of every day. Maybe when a good friend of yours stops talking to you. The Holy Spirit still flows through you to help you mend the problem, keep you calm, maybe create a healthy boundary around them, and maybe heal the hurt, or in time, maybe you find a new friend. That's the way all of life goes from your age until 100 years old. Jesus is the source of your strength, and your identity is being His follower, and that is freedom. Freedom to love, to care, to save, have a life in Him, to trust in how Jesus will rescue you when you're most needed. That's what today is truly all about. Reading the catechism and studying our faith, and reading Matthew's gospel every day as their homework, that learning about love and welcome and acceptance isn't so much about making sure you believe, but helping you see how wonderful it is to be loved and remain a follower of Jesus, because that's the content of what believing is. Faith is an active word. It's like love and mercy, compassion, all action words. And that is what affirming your baptism looks like right today. Less about the believing, the remembering, the belonging, and more about living the faith of Jesus in freedom, trusting that He has your back. And He has a place for you in the world that you live in your family, at your school, in jobs, in your activities, in the church family here, and at the table with Jesus, enjoying the meal of Jesus, enjoying His freedom. Affirming your baptism today says that you are loved and you will love freely as Jesus has set you all free. I remember when I was just starting to learn about being a pastor in the seminary years, I remember hearing a lot about professors telling me, you need to make sure people know about a faith they can die with. And I would stop and I'd remember, well, what about a faith you can live with? And that's what we're doing today, because honestly, the disconnection that people have from church and God and faith really has a lot to do with what we believe often doesn't make sense, or maybe it hasn't been made sense to us in our daily living. And that's a faith we can live with, that the simple faith we've had, that they had before I saw them a year ago, the faith mom and dad passed on them, and grandparents and aunts and uncles and church family, Sunday school, VBS, that's all here today too. So as special as today is, it's also not that special, because we're all special in Jesus Christ, because we all share that faith. Thanks be to God. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which goes beyond our human understanding, guard your hearts and lives in the one true faith in Jesus Christ, now and always. Amen. You may remain seated as we continue with our brief order of confession and forgiveness. Confession has two parts. First, that we confess our sins.
And second, that we receive forgiveness.
From the pastor as from God Himself, not doubting but firmly believing.
That the body of our sins are forgiven before God in heaven.
Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We are truly sorry, and we pray for forgiveness. We firmly intend to amend our lives and to seek help in mending what is broken. We ask for strength to turn from sin and to serve you with newness of life. Amen. As a called and ordained servant of the word, I announce the grace of God to all of you. And on behalf of my Lord Jesus Christ and by his command, I forgive you all your sins. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We continue with the gathering of the offering. Let us all rise for prayer. Reforming God, we give you thanks for your forgiveness and blessing. Fill us with a spirit of openness to your spirit, to hear and receive your promises, and that we live out our baptisms daily. Where we are corrupt, purify us. Where we are in error, direct us. Where we are in need, provide for us. Where we are divided, reunite us. And where we are closed-minded, reform us and make us new. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for all who long for a word of truth and for the radical grace that flows from your Son Jesus' cross. Inspire congregations to freely and boldly proclaim your love for all people with persistence and hope. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for all who aspire to public office and for all officials who govern your people here and nationwide. Pour wisdom and understanding upon all who administer the law so that communities of justice and peace may flourish. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for your creation, for mountains, rivers, streams, cities, farmlands, and neighborhoods. Write in our hearts a new love and care for creation. Give us the will to curb wasteful habits and to hold accountable those who neglect the vulnerable. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Our Lord Jesus healed the sick and gave new hope to the hopeless. Though we cannot demand your power over health, we pray for those who want to be healed. We ask your measure of blessing, especially today, upon Naomi, Karim and his family, all suffering in Ukraine, Russia, and the Middle East, in Israel, in Gaza. We pray for all those still affected by storms and fires here and around the world. For Sue and Jeff, for Sonia. We also pray for the bereaved of Mona Bartlett, who died this past week. We also include Donna Huffman's grandson, who is recovering from some burns to his legs. We pray for shut-in members, Pauline and John and Emily. Mend their wounds. Soothe fevered brows and make broken people whole again. Help us to welcome every healing in mind, body, and spirit as encouragement that you are for us and have promised renewed and risen life in Jesus. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give thanks for all those who have lived and died in you and helped reform your church on earth in every generation. Give us courage through their example to challenge unjust systems and work toward life-giving reformation. We pray through the reforming grace of Jesus Christ, who with you, O Father, and the Holy Spirit, lives and reigns as one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We continue by singing our Holy, Holy. Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Welcome to the Lord's table.
Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you in the true faith, and keep you in his grace until life everlasting.
Thank you.
Lord of life, Jesus Christ, in the gift of your body and blood in bread and wine, you turn the crumbs of faith into a feast of salvation unto eternal life. Send us forth into the world with shouts of joy, bearing witness to the abundance of your love as we radiate your love to the world. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
We close with our last song, This Little Light of Mine. Welcome to all of you gathered for our Holy Communion service today, celebrating Reformation and the affirmation of baptism for our youth here today. And for the parents and the youth that are here, just before we get away too fast, right after the service, we can come back for a couple of photographs so we can have those for our own church and for your own purposes for friends and family. And incidentally, the order of service, starting with the cover, and the songs were all really picked by the youth, the cover they actually voted on. So we had a whole bunch, and they chose, and all the music we listened to, they chose, and it was wonderful. And hopefully, if you haven't yet read their explanations of the Bible verses they chose for themselves, they're quite wonderful testaments of our faith. There is an announcement we need to make for the urns. If you go ahead, Wendy.
I know you've heard it all before, but somehow missed getting in the book this week. This is the last week. Payment. If you've talked to me and said, hey, I want to do this, that's awesome, I need your money now. I need it by Sunday, November the 5th, in order to, because I got to pay for this. It's a great night. The urns last well into March, April. There is fellowship before, and then the workshop starts promptly at 6:30. $75, and part of that is a donation to our own soul program. So, if you mention to me you want to join, come and see me. And there is still lots of room. If you're still thinking about it, please come and talk to me. Let me know. We have room for you. There's lots of room, and it's lots of fun. Thank you.
Thank you. There's also a cake and the refreshments downstairs, a chocolate and a white cake with the confirmand's names on, and so that's wonderful for all of us to share today, too. Oh, yes, Richard.
Is anybody who was at the Western Night 2 weeks back, if you came to me and had your picture taken, I have the pictures from the printer. I'm going to lay them out the back, so they'll be back here if you want to.
Oh, thank you very much. Yes, go ahead, Carol. Yes, you got to make a plug probably for the bazaar, yes.
So we're almost into November now, so it's getting closer to our bazaar. And in addition to the poster in here, I will be standing at the back when you go out, and I have extra posters and small invitations that you can hand out. So if you live in an apartment building or a condo, and you could put one of our posters up to help us advertise, that would be wonderful. Or you could take one of our little invitations and hand them out to your friends. There's also a whole thing you can read here about how you can help and how much we would appreciate your support. So see me at the back if you would be willing to put a poster up somewhere for us or hand out some invitations. Thanks. Oh,
thank you, Carol. I know last year I took some, and some of the Tim Hortons and Starbucks around will let you do that too if you ask, because they have bulletin boards. I've done that, and sometimes it was without the collar too, so they always said yes. So if you frequent any of those places around here, please do advertise. Did you have something?
I just wanted to put a little bit of a plug for a Jello on a Stick, which is happening in February for youth and confirmands.
February.
It's in November, and it's a day retreat. It used to be a full weekend, but now it's just a day retreat. So I'll be downstairs, and we can talk a little bit more about it if anybody's interested.
Thank you. We go in grace, serving our Lord in peace and joy. Thanks be to God.